David Ion, and today I'm going to show you how to take a rigid 18 volt lithium ion battery pack apart. It's, these are mass produced. They've got 18650 cells in them, and I'm going to tear it down and take those 18650 cells out of it. So, zoom in. So as you can see here, it's got torque screws in it. These are security torque screws. I mean, you need the ones with the holes in the middle. So we're gonna see what size this is. There we go. This particular pack has four on each side. So let's start taking it apart. Yeah, that's screeching like nails on a chalkboard right there. Now we'll flip it over, go to the other side. Take it out. I like to use these Ryobi, just they're a little bit smaller than a normal Ryobi drill, or they're just a little bit slower, and it gives you the ability to kind of have a little bit more control when you're taking these apart. So from here on these, you just push the buttons on the side here. Can see it releases the battery. On this one, you have a printed circuit board with a resistor, and really the on. I like to cut the leads on some of the other models. On this one, we're gonna have to take the screws out and actually pop the board up while it's still hot. So I'll go down. That looks like a number two Phillips here. So these are actually the connect points when you slide your charger in to charge, or your battery into your battery charger. So those are, you know, hot and balanced leads. Let's see if we can't go ahead and slide this thing out of the pack, if it'll come out or not. They stick a little bit. I like to come on the end of the where the heat sink is and pop the cells out. If this one will come out. Okay, that's gonna give me a hard time. So what we're gonna do is just lift the circuit board a little bit so we can start cutting the nickel strip. Right here, I'll just cut that. The main negative is a little bit hard to cut, as well as the main positive. Here's the soldering for it. I found it easier if you go ahead and cut the solder. It just makes it simpler. So on the main negative, main positive, we'll go ahead and cut the solder off of here. Off of the printed circuit board. All right, now I will go ahead and lift this up. And right here, you can see this thinner nickel here. I will go ahead and cut that. And there we go. Now we've got a little more safe there. Go ahead and lift this side. I'll cut the main positive here. Let me get it where y'all can see it. And these are just Play-Doh snippers. They work really well because they're flat and they can cut like that. So we've got that lifted. We'll come down and I just pop the nickel strip off of one side of the balance lead. And there's one more right here that I need to cut. As you can see right there, it's connected to the board. There you go. So here's the board. There's the heat sink to help cool it. And now we're inside the pack. We'll just pull the sides off here. This is a temperature sensor. I like to pull these off first because they're all gummy and it gets stuck in your tools and it's a pain. So let's come in. What I'm gonna do here is just get this nickel stripping off of here. So just grab a pair of pliers and pull, and I try to get it where it doesn't arc the circuit over or between the batteries, and one, it just scares you, and two, it can be dangerous. So I'll come in and get this next piece of nickel strip here. See if I can pull that off. And these batteries are spot welded on there, so try to keep at an angle so you're not arcing batteries one to the other. As you can see, that's decently clean on that side now. Let's do the other side. And on these particular rigid cells, they like to start coming out of the pack holder on you when you're taking them apart. So sometimes, like on this last one, I'll just pull it out. It's easier, yank it apart, get the negative side, pop this off, take that piece off. So now the rest of these cells just push out. And this one has LG cells in them. They're very common in power tools. They do really well. They're very good at high discharge rate. That's one of the reasons the manufacturers picked these. So now I like to just clean the tops off a little bit. You can see where the spot welding was there. So now it's a little cleaner looking. Find one. So on this one, you can see the spot welding is very protruded there. You don't want to deal with that later if you're trying to spot weld or solder. So let's just clip these off. And sometimes there's a little bit of an indent there. I'll flatten it just a little bit with a hammer, not too hard. And there you go. There's a tear down of a rigid. This is an R840085. Five cells in it. Later on, I'll show you how to condition shells in another video, and how you can reuse these in the packs and things like that. David Ion, I appreciate it, and like and subscribe.